Dear students, let's discuss the topic of collision. In collision, we can write that it is a process of momentum transfer by internal forces of a system. Whenever just by internal forces of a system, between bodies, transfer of momentum takes place, the phenomena is termed as collision. To analyze the phenomena of collision, we'll take up an example. Let us consider we are having two balls and say both are positively charged. These are having masses m1 and m2. Say the balls are moving with the speeds u1 and u2 along the same line of motion. And we know well that like charges repel each other. So, the two balls will experience an electric force we can term as Fe, which are acting on the two balls in opposite direction. Here, if we consider U1 is more than U2, say U1 is more than U2, then in this situation we can say as the first ball is moving fast, the separation between the two balls will decrease. Due to the force on the second ball by the first ball, the force is acting in the direction of speed. So, we can say here the speed of second ball will increase and the force due to the second ball on the first ball is in the direction opposite to speed. So, here speed of first ball will decrease. So, certainly after some time a situation will arise when the two balls will be moving at a minimum separation. Their separation will be minimum when the two balls will be moving with equal speeds, because the speed of second is increasing and that of first is decreasing. At some time when the speed becomes equal, we can say the separation between the two balls will be minimum. Again, if we talk about the electric force, still the force Fe would be acting in the same direction on the two balls. First ball will have increasing speed. Second ball, or the ball which is behind the first ball, will be having a decreasing speed. Now in this situation, again due to increase in speed of this ball and decrease in speed of this ball, the separation will further increase. Say their velocities changes to v1 and v2 and the separation is further increased. And certainly in the final state we can write v2 will be more than v1. Now, from the initial situation to the final situation, say time is from t equals to 0 to t equals to t. In the whole duration for a constant time, both the balls will be experiencing equal forces. So, we can state the amount of impulse applied to the second ball is exactly equal to the amount of impulse which is applied to the first ball in opposite direction. That means whatever momentum reduction takes place in the first ball is exactly equal to the gain in momentum in the first ball. Now in this situation, in the process of transfer of momentum, the situation when the separation between the balls is minimum and the speeds are equal, we can state this is the state of minimum kinetic energy during collision. So, in this situation, we can state in the collision, when a transfer of momentum takes place from one body to another, there will be an intermediate state when the bodies will move with equal speeds, and that is the state when the kinetic energy of system will be minimum. And here we can also see one thing, that there is no physical contact taking place between the bodies. So, in a collision, it is not necessary that the bodies will come in physical contact. And when our bodies come in physical contact, we'll study soon. That is called a special type of collision. We call it impact. Impact is the one where we can state physical contact occurs. So just be careful about the concept of collision. We'll study in detail with many other examples also. In the previous situation, we have studied when two balls which are positively charged moving with the speed u1 and u2 due to electric forces, which are the internal forces of system, transfer of momentum takes place. If U1 is more than U2, the separation between the balls will decrease. At an intermediate instant, when the speeds are equal, the separation between the balls, we can see that it is minimum separation, and in this state, the kinetic energy of system is also minimum. And finally, due to electric force further, when the second ball will accelerate higher, its speed V2 will be more than the speed V1 of first ball. So here we can state that the momentum of first ball is transferred to the second ball up to some extent, which depends on the magnitude of force and the time involved in the process. Here we can state as no external force is present in the above case, this implies total momentum of system will remain conserved. In this situation, total momentum of system will remain conserved. That means initial momentum was m1 u1 plus m2 u2. That was the momentum of the system of two balls if their masses are m1 and m2. Finally, the momentum will be m1 v1 plus m2 v2. This is a relation you need to use very carefully. So we can state that in a collision, total momentum of system always remain conserved as no external forces present. Let's now discuss the impact between two bodies. As we have just now studied that impact generally signifies physical contact. And in case of a normal collision between two bodies, let us again take up an example in which say we are having two balls with masses m1 and m2. So these are moving along the same line of motion with the speeds u1 and u2. Now in this situation, if u1 is more than u2, obviously the separation between the two balls will decrease and the first ball will hit the second ball after some time. So we can say due to the physical contact between the two bodies, a normal contact force appears between the two. Due to this normal contact, the speed of the second ball, which was u2, will increase as normal force is acting in the direction of speed, and the speed of first ball, which was u1, it will decrease as normal force due to contact is acting in opposite direction to that of u1. If you carefully analyze the situation and compare it to the previous case when the bodies were charged, so here, normal contact force is playing the similar role which was played by the electric force in the previous case. Now again, due to the type of material of bodies, some deformation may take place between the bodies. And due to this normal force, this U2 is increasing, U1 is decreasing. At some time, the speed of the two balls during contact will remain equal, will become equal. Now, in this situation, again, we can state the kinetic energy of the two ball system will be minimum when the speeds are equal. Now, after some time, due to this normal reaction, the bodies may get separated if the deformation will be recovered and the bodies will have different speeds V2 and V1. Here, the contact duration was very small. You can call it delta T. So, the normal force which was acting on the two balls was just for a duration delta T, which was equal. So, whatever impulse was supplied to the second ball in forward directions, the same impulse was supplied to the first ball in opposite direction. So, we can state here, due to the normal contact force, the momentum was transferred from first ball to the second ball. And finally, obviously, the speed of the second ball will be more than that of the first ball. Now, as we can state, here we can state as no external force is present, the total momentum of system will remain conserved. So here we can write throughout the process of collision, we can write momentum will remain conserved. So initial momentum was m1 u1 plus m2 u2. And the final momentum in the situation can be written as m1 v1 plus m2 v. So just be careful about conservation of momentum, which will always hold whenever no external force is present.